you see the tomb of Confucius. His body is still laying there. When you go to Mecca, Muhammad's body is still there. But I'm privileged to go to Jerusalem. Oh, the tomb where our Lord and Savior was buried is empty. It is empty. It is empty. Because death could not hold it captive. In Ghana, there was a fetish priest by the name Confucius Adonchi. He promised the Ashanti people that he's going to bring the remedy for death. He told the woman that they should not cry. And when you die, you resurrected. But one day, when he died, he tried to resurrect him. But death keep hold of him and said, it's only one person that overcome me. That's Jesus Christ. Today, Confucius told me that the body is still there. He could not resurrect him. I want you to understand that we are serving a living God who never lies. So this morning, as we are celebrating the resurrection power of God, it brings hope to our hopeless situation. Because in the blood, there's healing, there's freedom. So I know for sure that this morning, the Lord is with you. You see, the death of Christ, we cannot say that it's just an event. But it's something that the world cannot explain it. God, Jesus predicted his death. Even it was prophesied over 4,600 years before he was born. You know, the Bible said the lamb that was slain before the foundation of the earth is meant that Jesus was slain and resurrected before the foundation of this earth. So you and I testify that this God is a good God. His son has sent Jesus to die, and grave could not hold him captive. The mission, the reason why Jesus came on this earth, in Luke chapter 4, verse 18 to 19, Jesus said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He has anointed me to bring the good news, because the death and the resurrection of Christ is the good news. He has anointed them because Jesus came to bring the good news and also to set the captive free. Remember that when Adam sinned, the whole human being went into captivity. He was came into this world to release us from prison and also to give sight to the plan which many of us without Christ we are blind. He also came in to declare the favor back again, the grace back again. When Adam was created in the Garden of Eden, he was the grace of God. He had favor of God. He had blessing of God. He was sinless. He did not sin. He was not having any weakness in him. But because of that, all this weakness entered him. But Jesus came in to do what? Release us from those curses, oppression to redeem us. So when Jesus came and went to the cross, and he said something in John chapter 18, John 18, verse 28. If you read the whole book of John chapter 18, he's talking about the crucifixion of Christ. After he went through all the challenges, beaten, crucified, and many things, then Jesus, at the last about to die, he made a statement. Luke chapter 19, John chapter 19, verse 28. And later, knowing what had been complete, later, knowing that all was now complete. The completion is done. Jesus has paid the price. He knows that Bible has been fulfilled. Scriptures have come to pass. He came to bring the good news for you and I. heart be saved. He came to release those who were in prison. He came to set the captives free. He came so that oppressed shall be set free. He came so that the relationship and the communication and the communion with God that we lost because of sin shall be restored. So after Jesus hung on the cross and knowing now everything had been complete, so that the scripture will be fulfilled, Jesus said, I am thirsty. And then continue 29. A jar of vinegar was there. They soaked a sponge in it, put a sponge on a stand of the hyssop plant, and lifted up to Jesus' lips. When he received the drink, Jesus said, it is finished. My message to you this morning is titled, it is finished. Your pain, it is finished. Your sickness, it is finished. Your barrenness, it is finished. Every attack, it is finished. Every failure, it is finished. Because Jesus understands that he came to fulfill an assignment. So when he did that, with it, he bowed his head and gave up his spirit, which is his blood. Check, this is what Jesus came onto this world to do. He knew it is finished. He saved the mankind. All what the devil came to destroy, the Bible said, the people the devil came on this world is to destroy. But Jesus came and revised it and fit the problems of the devil had created. So after you have finished everything, with confidence that I am done my assignment, he said, it is finished. Church, why you trouble yourself? But many times Christians don't understand the redemptive power on the cross, what Christ did for us. He has paid the price. He has done everything for us. So the resurrection is a symbolic of a victory over the enemy. Hallelujah. Luke chapter 24, verse 1-7. When Jesus died, and the Bible said they carried him to the tomb. On the third day of the week, very early in the morning, the women said, the women, not the men, not the men, the women. You see, there's something spectacular about women that you cannot explain it. Their love for God is different. When men were hiding, the women was on the way to the tomb. And if you look, those who went to this house with me, from the upper room to the tomb will be about 3-4 miles. And it's not a level ground, it's a mountain way. But these 3 or 4 women, Mary, Magdalene, Joanna, and Mary again, Thomas' mother, and all these people, and in the morning, Bible said, I believe that the whole night from Friday to Sunday morning, they were not sleeping, they were concerned, they were preparing spices to go and take care of the body of Christ. Though they went there with a different agenda, but they did well. Very early in the morning, the women took the spice, they had prepared and went to the tomb. Verse 2 quickly. They found the stone run away from the tomb. Hallelujah. If you read another version of the gospel, when on their way going, Bible said they were contemplating that who is going to roll away the stone. Because the stone is so heavy. It's not just an ordinary stone, it is so heavy. Because the Jewish culture, when a body is buried and are very prominent, they have a special stone put at the entrance of the grave. Who is going to roll away the stone? You know, sometimes people don't know that there's so many challenges in our life that become like a stone. It has become a stone. Your darkness has become a stone. The fruit of your womb has become like a stone. And your education, you tremble, you struggle. want to scold, but it becomes like a stone. Your children are rebellious and it becomes like a stone. Sometimes you ask yourself, will this stone be rolled away? But Bible said, at that night of the resurrection, angels were sent from heaven to roll away the stone. I promise to somebody that every stone that is stepping you, that bringing challenges, that brings tears to you, the stone will be rolled away. For the angel of the Lord has sent it to your life because of the resurrection. The stone. And when they enter the body of the Lord, did not find him. They could not find Jesus. And verse 4 said, while they were wondering about this, suddenly two men in the cloth that lived like a lantern stood behind them, beside them. And verse 6, in their flight, the women bowed down with their face to the ground. But the men said to them, why do you look for the living among the dead? What? Many times, you know, we don't understand the power of resurrection. Christ, dead and resurrected, have bring life into a situation. Their situation have received life. The tomb that the enemy tried to pierce your children, pierce your miracle, have because of the resurrection, it is empty. I want you to understand that. Don't look for your business in a dead area. Look it in the resurrection power. Resurrection power comes in. Nothing can be dead in your life. Your marriage can be dead, can never be dead. Why? Because there's a resurrection. He said, why are you living, looking for the living among the dead? Jesus that you are looking for, he's no more dead. He's alive. And I want every one of us to know that this resurrection power has brought hope into your hopeless situation. Anything that is said is dead in you. Trust me, by this anointing and the power of the Holy Ghost that brought Jesus from dead, it is upon your life. Your business will come back alive. Your marriage will come back alive. Your children will come back alive. Your academic will come back alive. Anything that looked like dead, there's going to be a resurrection in Jesus' name. You know, last man of May, when I got the COVID, one of the days I told you the story, I died. I saw me leaving my body. Because when you leave your body, your spirit gets up. Not immediately you go. For some few seconds, you stand there and look at the body. So I was standing there as my spirit had left my body, and I see my body. So I look at my body for a few seconds and then gone. When I'm about to enter into heaven, I was stopped. I said, no, it's not your time. And when I believe the voice was Jesus, so this is not your time, it's not. You need to go back because you, many people's life depend on you. Many people were crying for you. You have to go back. And when they said that, go back, immediately I saw thunder, I saw shaking, so many things happened at that particular time. And the Spirit of God carried my spirit back into my body. That's what the Bible said. The spirit that lifted Jesus from death, if that spirit is in you, brothers and sisters, the spirit that brought me from heaven back to earth, I've never experienced something like that. It was so serious. Carry me back to my body. The spirit that lifted Jesus back from there. So I want you to understand, brothers and sisters, nothing will die in your life without the permission of God. And God knows you. And you will tell that by today, as we celebrate the resurrection power, of God, the spirit and that power, and that anointing is in your life. Nothing will kill you before your time. Your business will not die. Your marriage will not die. Nothing will die because of the resurrection. Why are you looking for the living among the dead? Acts chapter 20, Acts chapter 2, verse 24. Acts 2, 24. Quickly. But God raised him from there, fleeing from the agony of death, because it was impossible for death to hold him captive. Jesus was raised from death by God. So when people are saying that Jesus, I remember one time ago, there's some people who make a movie and they titled it The Last Temptation of Jesus Christ. Has somebody watched it before? And they said that when Jesus was on the cross, his disciples came and took the body of Jesus and they ran to India. They said Jesus was not dead finished. They took him and ran to India and Mary Magdalene became his wife. And they said they have children over there. Have you watched that movie before? Oh my God. Has somebody watched it? Because it came when we were in Germany. And it was a big mess in Europe when the people were watching it and said, oh, Christ didn't die when he was rescued by his disciples and they took him to India. He settled there. He had grandchildren there. They have seen his family. What a lie! What a lie! Jesus was crucified. Jesus was dead. He was buried. But God raised him from the dead. God, Bible said, it is impossible for death to hold him captive. That's why in the book of Revelation chapter 1, Jesus himself said, I was dead, but alive. Put Revelation chapter 1 verse 18 for me. Put it there quickly. COVID has done very bad thing to church, taking away all our time. This massive man to preach like 2 hours. I am the living one. I was dead. And behold, I am alive forever and ever. I hold the keys of death and Hades. So don't let anybody tell you that Jesus was not dead. I saw the tomb. And there's a testimony. The Bible makes it clear. After resurrection, he is showing himself for many of the people. Hallelujah. John chapter 11, verse 25. Jesus told Martha, I am the resurrection and power. Jesus be the resurrection and power. Whoever believes in him, even if he died, he will live again. Brothers and sisters, we will live again. There's no hope for our future. When we die, we'll be resurrected. Because the one that we follow, death could not hold him captive. Death could not hold Jesus captive. He's resurrected. He has arisen. So have that confidence in you. That as you believe in this Jesus, and his spirit is in you, nothing in you will die. Hallelujah. They will try, but it will not work. Quickly, for the next 5 minutes, let me give you about 10 benefits of the resurrection. Number one, you will conquer fear. You have conquered fear. Hebrews chapter 2, verse 15, quickly put it there. You have conquered fear. Hallelujah. And those who are all ever held in slavery by the fear of death, Jesus have given power over fear. The Bible said in 1 John, I think chapter 5, it said, we have overcome the world by our faith. I want you to know that you have conquered the world. Number two, you can be confident in your future. Hallelujah. Because of resurrection, you have conquered fear and you have a confidence in your future. Jeremiah chapter 1, is 29 verse 1. He said, I know the plan that I have for you. A good plan, a good future. Then that will bless your life. So, brothers and sisters, by believing in our Lord Savior and the Lord and Savior Jesus, you have a future. Don't let anybody tell you that your future is not bright. in your father, not in your mother, not in your father, not in your pastor. Your future is in the hands of the resurrection power. Because Jesus arrived, we have tomorrow. Because of tomorrow, we cannot fear tomorrow. Number three, you are empowered to do exceeding great. Ephesians chapter 3, he said, you know, God who can do exceeding more than you can imagine or think. Who are giving them the power? Because of the cross and the resurrection, you are empowered. You should not be afraid of the enemy. Number four, because of resurrection, you are the church. And he said, I build you as a church, and the gate of hell cannot prevail. No demon, no death, no sickness, no bad water, no evil can overcome you. Why? Because you are the church. He built the church and the people in the church. Number five, you are in change. Renewal of our mind. Romans chapter 12. He said, of the resurrection, we renew our mind. We should not conform with the world. We should not behave like a worldly do things. Hallelujah. 1 John chapter 5 verse 4 number 6 said, you are the victory. You are the victory. Remember when your team that you support is winning, you see. Yesterday I couldn't have the time to watch. I wake up in the morning later and I saw that my team have been beating 5-2. Oh my God. I said, wow, why did I forget the time? It is good that I didn't watch it because I'll be very sad. But if your team is winning, remember, when your team is winning, you are on the victory side. You see the joy. You see the happiness inside of you. You are so excited. That's the day that you eat your food everywhere. That's the day that you enjoy. It is a winner to make sure your husband enjoys to rest somehow. Because there's a victory. You are the victory. You have overcome the world. You are the victory. Hallelujah. Number seven, he has a lordship over you. God controls us because he bought us by the blood. He has a lordship. Romans chapter 1 verse 4, that sentence says, time will not permit us to read all. Number eight, you are born again. As many as receive him, he gives them power to become the children of God. As many as receive Jesus, as many as receive the resurrection power and believe them, he gives them the power to become born again. One of the things also, the resurrection has given power over sin. Power over sin. Power over death. Hallelujah. And number nine, you have an everlasting life. That we are not afraid of death. Even if we die today, there's a hope. I'm going to spend eternity with my Lord. Apostle Paul said, there's one thing that I'm torn in between, to leave this tent and be with the Lord. On Friday, I was making a statement that when a Christ-like person die, a Christian die, you go and see his or her face on a dead bed, smiling. Wow. Because when the angels came out and meet him or her, she feels joy, happy. One day, Reverend Opuni, our spiritual father, tell a story about there was a man in Central Assemblies of God, Kumasi. That man, when he became a born again, he was about 70 years. And at that time, had about three wives. At that time, before he became converted. So the Assemblies of God was encouraging him to divorce all the last two. And then you meet them with the first one. And say, Papa, now, you know, I don't need nothing. They are like my sisters. I don't want to put them into anything. So he was not being baptized. They didn't give him communion. And he was dying. He said, when the angels were coming one time, he told them, you see, you never baptized me. But on my sick bed, I'm dying. See, the angels have appeared. And then, within a minute of making that statement, the man died. So, Reda was saying that sometimes we judge people based on what we know, but their relationship with God is only God who knows what you have for them. A you face man. I've seen people also die. They die like fear. You see somebody die and then one day angels are coming and you know that you go to hell. He was afraid. But we have eternal life because of the resurrection. Hallelujah. The last one, because of resurrection, he has redeemed us from curses. Galatians chapter 3, verse 30, please, as I finish my way. Galatians chapter 3, verse 30. Galatians. Christ redeemed us from the curse of the law by becoming a curse, for it is written, curse is everyone who hung on the tree. Verse 14. He redeemed us in order that the blessing given to Abraham must come to the Gentiles through Christ Jesus, so that by faith we may receive the promise of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah! You have been redeemed by the blood and by the resurrection power. So I want you to know that resurrection power has bring hope into our life. Don't see yourself as a failure, but see yourself that somebody died and paid the price. The resurrection power has set us free from captivity. The resurrection power has broken every written code against our life. The resurrection power has destroyed everything that stood and opposed our blessing. The resurrection power has taken away every sickness, every disease against our life. The resurrection power has taken away every poverty and every setback from our life. The resurrection power has opened door for us to have access to heaven. But without going to anybody, the resurrection power has made us connected to the grace of God, that we can stand and say, Abba, Father. The resurrection power has redeemed us from captivity. Today, because of the resurrection, you are a child of God. Let's be on our feet. But ladies, men come and sing this song that I love it. The cross, you know, the good. I thought that one we are going to sing.